The peak in a solar cycle, solar maximum, and global seismic energy are highly connected to changes on Earth, environmental changes, and animal and human behavior. Every one of us is connected to the ever-going cyclical changes of the universe. We just seem to have forgotten this in our modern lifestyle. We are moving a lot closer to the peak in solar cycle 25. And with the extreme solar flares on the equinox, and now the upcoming total solar eclipse on April 8th, we are in a rapid movement of changing light. I would almost say a bombardment of protons and light from the sun that might influence our mind, body, and spirit. For some reason, this time it is also connected to Easter period, symbolizing resurrection and renewal, the resurrection of light. This is the 24th video in the series Basic Ways of Healing Yourself in Nature. In the years 1997 to 1999, a group of scientists and doctors revealed the connection between geomagnetic variables and behavior. They also found out that there is a connection between solar activity and armed conflicts throughout history. I quote, "A factor associated with geomagnetic activity might, it is speculated, modulate changes within emergent processes that control the relative dominance of large aggregates of humans. Wars may have been the more obvious manifestations of these changes." End of quote. In the last 20 to 30 years, there has been a big amount of science going on that has proved how the 11-year sun cycles connect to human behavior. Wars, pandemics, human health issues, and changes in consciousness. If you start to observe the changes in the sun for yourself, you will realize that you also react to these changes. I will link to a wide range of scientific material in the description box below. There is growing interest in the potential link between solar cycles and societal trends. Some studies have suggested correlations between solar activity and phenomena such as economic cycles, crime rates, and even political upheavals. While the exact nature of these connections remains a subject of debate, they highlight the interconnectedness of human societies with the broader rhythms of the cosmos. Since the start of this solar cycle, science has proved to be right. As you will remember, this solar cycle started out with a worldwide pandemic. And we have seen how the temperatures are rising fast towards the peak in the solar cycle. Things from ancient times reappear for our eyes. Here I especially will mention the Hunger Stones in Central Europe, telling their silent story about how Earth has been here before in another extreme solar cycle, and that humans made these to warn the future. In this part of the video, I will mention that I know that environmental changes are not only because of the peak in the solar cycle, but I have to address that the solar cycle and the upcoming peak also have an influence on the situation. And that this should be a thing that world leaders should begin to acknowledge before we might enter a new Carrington event that seems to be possible around autumn this year, 2024. The sun is flipping its poles, and to think that we should not be affected by this is not possible. This is the real reason why we all should prepare for possibly weeks of power outage. Not only because of terror or wars, but mainly because the sun is now really manifesting its power over us. So how do you best adapt to these ongoing and peaking changes in our natural environment? To begin with, all my videos in this series connect to how you become and return to unite with nature. It explores how you integrate nature into your everyday life, utilizing your ordinary senses, sight, hearing, taste, smell and touch, as well as the less recognized senses of body position and movement, temperature, pain, balance, and perhaps the most crucial one, the sense of time. Start by following the changes in space weather on official sites, which I will link to in the description. Learn how your own body, mind and behavior change during peaks in solar weather, and prepare yourself for possible conflicts and unusual occurrences when extreme G3 to G5 solar storms from the sun hit Earth. Make time for a walk during the daytime, regardless of whether it's raining or shining. Just be out there walking and sense your natural surroundings, whether you live in a city or in the countryside. Connect with nature. It encompasses everything outside, from the air you breathe to the ground you walk on. Take deep breaths in through your nose. Hold it for a while. Count to six. And breathe out. Make this a daily practice. Even a short 10-minute walk will immediately improve your well-being. So prioritize this in your everyday life. It's free, and it will benefit your life in only positive ways. By connecting with the sun's cycle in this manner, you also learn how to interconnect with the world around you. You enhance your ability to be kind and to read human behavior through changes in light. Because, my dear friends, as I speak on this Easter day, kindness and light, kindness and the sun, are interconnected. The sun, as the primary source of light and warmth for our planet, plays a central role in seasonal celebrations. As the days grow longer and the sun rises higher in the sky, there is a palpable sense of awakening and rejuvenation in the natural world. Trees begin to bud, flowers bloom, and animals emerge from hibernation. All signs of life returning after the dormancy of winter. In Christian tradition, the resurrection of Christ is often symbolized by the rising sun, representing the triumph of life over death. The imagery of light breaking through the darkness mirrors the spiritual significance of Easter. As believers rejoice in the victory of good over evil and the promise of salvation. While Easter may not hold the same religious significance within Buddhist and other religious traditions as it does in Christianity, there are nonetheless shared themes of renewal, rebirth, and spiritual awakening that resonate across different faiths and cultures. Culturally, solar cycles have been intertwined with human beliefs, rituals, and traditions for millennia. Many ancient civilizations worshipped the sun, recognizing its role in sustaining life and fertility. Studies have suggested correlations between solar cycles and certain physiological phenomena. Research has linked solar activity to fluctuations in heart rate variability, blood pressure, and even the incidence of cardiovascular events. While the mechanisms underlying these associations are still being studied, it's clear that our bodies respond to changes in solar activity in subtle yet significant ways. Humans are deeply connected to solar cycles through a complex interplay of biological, cultural, and societal factors. As we continue to study and understand these connections, we gain insights into the profound influence of the sun on our lives and the relationships that shape our existence on Earth. Be open to the ebb and flow of life and embrace the changes that come with increasing light. Stay flexible and adaptable in your approach, and trust in your ability to navigate whatever lies ahead. Prioritize self-care practices that nourish your body, mind, and spirit. Get adequate rests, eat nourishing foods, engage in physical activity, and participate in activities that bring you joy and fulfillment. Use the return of light as an opportunity to set new intentions or goals for yourself. Whether it's personal growth, creative pursuits, or wellness habits, harness the energy of increasing light to propel yourself forward. I will, as always, put some links in the description box below, and I will return soon with new content on this channel. Please share, like, and subscribe, and hit the notification bell if you want to get noticed about new content on my channel. Don't forget to mark your calendars and observe the upcoming solar eclipse on April 8th. It is an extraordinary astronomical event that offers a unique opportunity to witness the amazing dance between the sun, moon, and earth. And as always, stay kind and shine.